residents in non-Muslim countries. The issue: a Muslim may leave a Muslim country to live in a non-Muslim one. This may have an influence on his faith and allegiance. Ruling. Scholars have expressed two different views on this question. The first view says that a Muslim leaving a Muslim country to live in a non-Muslim one is permissible provided that he is able to declare his faith without being harmed and does not fear to yield to temptation. The permissibility is even more valid if he is able to strengthen the condition of Muslims there and provide them with knowledge and advocacy of Islam. Otherwise, it is not permissible. This is the view expressed by Sheikh Abd al-Aziz ibn Baz, Sheikh Muhammad ibn Uthaymeen, Sheikh Abdullah ibn Jibreen and Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan. This view is endorsed by the European Council for Fatwa and Research, which goes further to say that such residence is recommended if the Muslim concerned can positively participate in society and introduce the great features of Islam and its high moral standards. It considers such residence obligatory if the other option is likely to cause harm or have clear adverse effects and he can repel such effects. Evidence. The first view considers that when a Muslim is able to practice his faith openly, then his residence in a non-Muslim country brings about greater benefit than any likely harm. The benefit includes strengthening the Muslim community, spreading knowledge and advocating the true divine faith, and introducing Islam and its great features, good manners and superior morality to non-Muslims. On the other hand, if a Muslim is unable to practice his faith openly, or if he fears to be tempted or pressured away from his faith, then residence in a non-Muslim country is not permissible. This is based on the Quranic verse that says, "Put no trust in those who do wrong, lest the fire scourge you. You would, then, have none to protect you from God, nor would you find any help." 11:113. God also says, "Believers, do not take the unbelievers for your allies in preference to the believers. Do you want to place before God a manifest proof against yourselves?" 4:144. The Prophet says, "I disown any Muslim who lives among the idolaters." Related by Abu Dawood, Hadith number 2645. The second view considers it obligatory for a Muslim to leave the land of unbelievers, even though he happens to be a national of such a country. This is the view of Sheikh Nasir al-Albani. Evidence. In support of the second view, the Quranic verse, "To those whom the angels gather in death while they are still wronging themselves, the angels will say, 'What were you doing?' They will answer, 'We were oppressed on earth.' The angels will say, 'Was not God's earth so spacious that you might have migrated to settle elsewhere?' Such will have their abode in hell, a certainly evil end." 4:97. The Prophet says, "I disown any Muslim who lives among the idolaters." Related by Abu Dawood, Hadith number 2645. The Prophet also said to someone, "I will accept your pledge that commits you to worship God alone, to attend regularly to your prayers, to pay the zakat, offer good advice to Muslims and part with the unbelievers." Related by Al-Nasai, Hadith number 4177.